Introduction to Algorithm of Subtraction.
Hello friends, I am your friend the Parrot and I welcome you to this topic. Come on, let us see what you will learn in this lesson. How to subtract a small number from a large number in a systematic way. Today Chotu has gone for his friend Sonu's birthday party. Look, there are so many balloons. While leaving, Chotu decides to take 7 balloons with him.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now I will take these 7 balloons home and play with them.
On the way, he meets his friend Aarti. She has just returned from her grandma's place in another city.
Oh wow, Chotu, these are such colorful balloons. Yes, Aarti, I will take them home and play with them. Do you also want some balloons?
Yes, Chotu, can you please give me 3 balloons?
Yes, Aarti, take these 3 balloons.
Thank you, Chotu.
Then after reaching home, he shows all the balloons to his mother.
Look, Mummy, I got these balloons to play with from Sonu's birthday party.
Oh wow, Chotu, how many balloons did you get?
I got 7 balloons from the party. But on the way, I met Aarti and I gave 3 balloons to her.
So now can you tell me, if out of the 7 balloons, you gave 3 balloons to Aarti, then how many balloons are left with you?
Yes, Mummy, I have 4 balloons left with me.
Very good, Chotu, you are absolutely right.
So friends, in this example, you saw that if from 7 balloons, we subtract 3 balloons, then 4 balloons are left. Come, let us see how to write this in a systematic way. On subtracting 3 from 7, 4 are left. 7 minus 3 equals 4. Did you understand, children? So now, if out of these 4 balloons, 2 balloons burst, then how many balloons are left? Yes, 2 balloons. Can you also write this in systematic way? On subtracting 2 from 4, 2 are left. This means 4 minus 2 equals to 2. Did you have fun subtracting the number of balloons? That is all for today. In this video, we learned how to subtract a small number from a large number, that too in a proper and systematic way. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of writing the subtraction of 2 numbers in a systematic way. Till then, bye friends!
Examples of Algorithm of Subtraction, Part 1.
So children, in the previous video, you learned how to subtract a small number from a large number in a systematic way. In this video, we will see some more interesting examples of writing the subtraction of 2 numbers in a systematic way. Pinky is strolling in the garden with her mother. She sees some butterflies on a bunch of flowers.
Mummy, look, there are such beautiful and colorful butterflies.
Yes, Pinky. Can you tell me how many butterflies are there on that bunch of flowers?
Yes, Mummy. There are 8 butterflies on it.
Very good, Pinky. You are absolutely right.
Pinky goes a little closer to the flowers to see the butterflies more closely, and 3 butterflies fly away.
Oh-ho! 3 butterflies flew away.
Out of 8 butterflies, 3 butterflies flew away. So how many butterflies are left on the flower?
5 butterflies are left, Mummy.
Very good, Pinky. You are absolutely right.
So, children, you saw that if we subtract 3 from 8, then 5 is left. Can you write this in a systematic way? Yes, this is how we will write it in a systematic way. 8 minus 3 equals to 5. Friends, do you know that we can write this in another way also? You don't know? Don't worry, I will tell you. We can also write it in this way. First, there were a total of 8 butterflies. So, we will write the total number on top. Then, 3 butterflies flew away. So, below the total number, we will put the subtraction sign and write the number that got reduced. Then, we will write the remaining number, which is 5 butterflies. So, children, from 8 butterflies, 3 butterflies flew away. So, 5 butterflies were left. You have understood, right? Come on. Now, let's go back to Pinky and her mother in the garden. Now, Pinky goes a little more close to the flowers to see the remaining 5 butterflies more closely. As soon as she goes near the flowers, all 5 butterflies fly away.
Oh, Mummy. All 5 butterflies flew away.
Don't worry, Pinky. There are so many butterflies in this garden. You will see them on some other flower.
So, children, now can you tell me if out of the 5 butterflies, all the 5 butterflies flew away, then how many butterflies are left? There are not even a single butterfly left on the flower. This means 0 butterfly was left. You also got the same answer, right? Very good. So, children, did you see that if we subtract 5 from 5, then 0 is left? Come on, now let us write this also in a systematic way. You also wrote it like this, right? Great! That was all for today. In this video, we learned how to represent the subtraction of 2 numbers in different systematic ways. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples and learn about some common mistakes that should not be made. Till then, bye friends!
Examples of algorithm of subtraction. Part 2.
So, children, in the previous video, you learned how to represent the subtraction of 2 numbers in different systematic ways. In this video, we will see some more interesting examples of subtraction and learn about some common mistakes that should not be made. Today is Sunday. Tomorrow is Aarti's birthday, who is Chotu and Pinky's friend. Pinky has brought 4 toffees for Aarti.
Pinky, please give me 1 toffee.
No, Chotu. These 4 toffees are for Aarti. I can't give you even 1 of these. I will get more toffees for you tomorrow.
Oh, okay. Fine, Pinky.
So, children, out of the 4 toffees, Pinky did not give even a single toffee to Chotu. This means she gave only 0 toffee. We can also write this in this way. Can you tell me the answer? Do you think the answer for this will be 0? No, right? The answer will be 4. You also got the same answer, right? Very good. This means 4 minus 0 equals to 4. If we subtract 0 from a number, that is, if nothing is subtracted, then the answer is that number itself. Did you understand?
Okay, now I will make a birthday card for Aarti. There are so many colorful pencils in that box. Can you give me some of those pencils, Chotu?
Yes. Take these, Pinky.
Thank you, Chotu.
So, children, first there were 9 pencils in the pencil box. And Chotu gave some of them to Pinky. Now there are 6 pencils left in the box. So can you tell me how many pencils did Chotu give to Pinky? Come on, let's see. First there were 9 pencils. If we take out 1 pencil from them, then there will be 8 pencils left. If we take out 2 pencils, then there will be 7 pencils left. If we take out 3 pencils, then there will be 6 pencils.
This means Chotu gave 3 pencils to Pinky.
We can solve this in another way. There were 9 pencils in the box, and after Chotu took some pencils, 6 pencils were left. This means out of 9 pencils, 6 pencils were left. So Chotu must have taken these 3 pencils. That means 9 minus 3 equals to 6. So children, that was all for today. In this video, we learned how to solve the subtraction questions in a systematic way. I hope you have understood this topic properly. Bye, friends!